Every story has a beginning. Discover the origin of evil.
Why are you back here, Claire? Your conspiracies weren't true when we were kids. They're not true now.
We need to expose Umbrella.
Watch this.
I'm afraid, Claire. I'm afraid of what they're gonna do to this town. You see, Umbrella, they had an incident. I'm talking Chernobyl, if you know what I mean. People are getting sick. You gotta help us, Claire. Let the world know what's really going on.
Shall we go?
For a destination. Into a crisis of times when I'm lying in bed. Just to get it all out. What's in my head? I am feeling.
What were Umbrella doing here?
This is where they're experimenting on him.
We should split up.
Art is the most valuable thing you can possess. Powerful people from every century have even gone to the length of killing to obtain a masterpiece.
Woo! Oh my God!
The gallery is too much of a risk. They want their money back in 48 hours, John.
The Pink Marilyn, it's my inheritance.
Faster! Faster!
My father promised it to me, and I want it back, because it's mine.
How did you get this?
If you ask me, it looks like a 5-year-old could have done it. But I want a bigger cut, because I found it, all right?
Tell me the truth, John. Those men were there for you.
You're gonna have to trust me.
It's time.
I'll give him a nice welcome. Cool.
Where's the party?
I can't take this anymore. It's over.
No, it isn't.
Whoever stole my painting, they're suicidal.
Please, no.
Bring Marilyn, and we won't hurt her.
I'm gonna give them what they want.
can get you out of this, you know.
Ain't no way you can keep up.
Get me out of what?
Ah, see, now that's exactly what I'm hoping you're gonna tell me.
This is Twist, extreme graffiti artist. Reaching places others can't reach. Then be fast.
Brilliant.
Come with us.
Mr. Twist, what else can I call you?
Oliver.
It appears that you're a connoisseur of beauty.
What do you see?
It's a really decent copy.
I've seen the original tons of times, the tape.
No, you haven't.
I know you're pulling a job. I want in. You're hitting Losburn.
Once prestigious art dealer.
He took everything from me. Everything. Used to kill, but I gave it up on my relapse. Now I'm going to return the favor.
We're on. Hey, no way you can keep
up! To pull this job off, you'll need a twist. Keep
up! My kids are not disposable.
That's exactly what they are. Keep up! You better break us like clockwork.
Be careful who you trust, because people only see what they want to see. Not if you know where to look.
I just feel like sometimes I'm not alone in the house. I'm really scared.
My name is Father William Roberts. I believe I was speaking with your partner earlier on today.
This is going to be good for us.
I'm sure it will. It seems like you're not the only one that's seen this.
You have seen the entity. My guess is it's attached itself to you already.
Do you feel a presence with us now?
Since the other night, it's never left.
Where is it?
Everywhere.
Listen to yourself. You sound nuts.
Defend us in battle and protect us against the wickedness and tyranny of the devil.
Lucy?
No matter what anyone says, don't let him in.
Burn in the eternal flames of hell.
Resist the dark spirit.
You're about to meet the greatest warriors the world has ever known. Legendary. Fashionable. Powerful.
Well, I'm sure that was a lot of fun for you.
It was.
On November 5th, the Marvel Universe...
Play nice.
...becomes eternal.
So, what's your superpower?
You know that your babysitting privileges are completely revoked, right? Marvel Studios Eternals, rated PG-13. Only in theaters November 5th.
We're Eternals. We came here to protect humans from the Deviants.
When you love something, you fight for it.
Dad, I saw him on TV with the cape shooting laser beams.
I don't wear a cape.
Protect any of them.
Let's finish this.
Marvel Studios Eternals, rated PG-13. Only in theaters November 5th.
He's here.
Cyrano?
Cyrano.
Pleasure to meet you, Cyrano de Bergerac.
You're a freak. Freak.
Ask Fent. He'd be very angry with you if you died.
My sole purpose on this earth is to love Roxanne.
Does she know?
The world will never accept someone like me and a tall, beautiful woman.
We have no money. A clever marriage is your only option.
I won't be rescued. I'm not in distress. Love, does that mean nothing to you?
Children need love. Adults need money.
I need something to die for. Write poems and cry for. And I won't be ashamed. I'd give anything for someone to say that they can't live without me. Confession to make. I am madly in love.
Perhaps he feels the same.
But I've never actually spoken to him.
Of your love?
Of anything. He is Christian. Christian Nubilet. He's a new recruit in your regiment.
Of course he is.
A woman like Roxanne wants wit, romance, poetry. I don't know how to speak romantically.
I am a poet. My words upon your lips.
I will make you romantic. Will you make me handsome?
She loves me!
I give anything for someone to say. All the words I don't have and I can't put together. I give anything.
Speak to me like you do in your letters.
You are a beautiful flower.
I am not a flower. I need more.
You're in love with her.
My fate is to love her from afar.
We must let her decide our fate. She must have the choice.
Nothing can ruin this night.
One of you could be the murderer.
Timber!
Can we all just agree that it's clear that Anique killed him?
Oh my God, no, I didn't. I'm guessing you're Anique.
She's good.
You know, it's a great way to deflect being a murderer is to accuse everybody else of murder. I'm with child!
That makes sense. You kill someone and birth a new one in. The number stays the same.
Hit it!
How did this all go so wrong?
I need my popcorn.
Oh, you actually have popcorn?
We're Eternals. We came here to protect humans from the deviants.
When you love something, you fight for it.
Dad, I saw him on TV with the cape shooting laser beams.
I don't wear a cape.
Let's finish this.
Marvel Studios Eternals, rated PG-13, only in theaters November 5th.
Season 3, we're back.
Woo!
I'm back and I'm blonde. Woo! Hey guys, it's Selena. I have learned so much about cooking the past 2 seasons, but I'm realizing I have only scratched the surface. So I am continuing my lessons with the help of my friends.
Oh,
let's get the groceries.
That's what we're cooking today.
Oh, I'm so excited that you're on my show. Thank you.
Woo!
We are going to be making the ultimate,
ultimate
watch party.
Game night.
Birthday bash menu.
That sounds amazing. I'm not great with knives. I'm just going to throw it out there.
We've got an injury.
We're in season 3. You got to be a little bit okay with knives by this point.
Bottoms up.
Cheers. Cheers. Oh my gosh.
So today it's all about a seafood soiree.
I'm gonna teach you how to make a South Indian brunch.
We're gonna freeze the ice cream base with liquid nitrogen.
Wow.
Oh, look at that.
This would not have happened season 1. This is my favorite meal I've ever made.
Hell yeah. Season 3. We got the triple threat going. Looking good, smelling good, Woo! Cooking good.
He's cute.
Yeah, you're cute. Thank you.
I think you're cute too.
Wait, what is happening?
Was he talking to me or you?
Me.
Don't be getting flustered on me now. We're here to cook.
That's our cooking show, folks. Ice cream, chillin', ice cream, chillin'. I see you.
Don't be blushing over there. Stop it.
Give him time.
Why are my dreams getting worse? What did you do to us?
Don't worry. I'm just gonna ask you some questions.
A royal trouble-free companion, given to you upon arrival.
20 years ago, a corporation made artificial people, called them replicants, hoping they'd do all our heavy lifting without ever complaining.
Humanity would have starved without you. But ideas mean nothing without the money and power to actualize it.
Police units are on route.
Suspect is female, 20s.
LAPD, stop!
What are we up against?
You said you had it all under control. How do you expect to control nature?
In the world of Sea, you can be the queen. You can be a leader of a tribe. You can be a warrior. Each individual is treated as an equal in our show.
I gotta do something as an actor that I've never done before. I've worked so hard to play a character like this.
It was just incredible to work with Joe. He's a producer, he's blind, and he's there to further the development of the characters in the best way possible.
Here's Joe Stretcher to give you some more advice.
It's beautiful to have someone like Joe and help me through it.
We wanted to make sure we were representing our community positively. So we looked at the littlest behaviors and how characters who are blind move in the world.
I went in completely open-minded, and Joe will come up and give me his notes, and I'll say I just never even thought about it that way.
We try to do everything we can to make sure that this feels authentic for the blind community, and Joe is key in that.
We have numerous actors who are blind or low vision, and we want to make sure that their needs are met when they come to work.
This was amazing. It was just such an experience. I was treated just with the utmost care and respect.
Everyone has such a good relationship, and here everyone's like, you're an actor, you're with us.
We fight for our families. We fight for our freedom.
We try to make sure that our characters who are blind aren't using nonverbal communication, you know, like even nodding the head yes or shaking the head no.
We're gonna use our ears to listen, right? We're not looking at him speak, we're listening to him speak, right?
Physical gestures mean very little in this world.
If you're moving your hands, it should be purposeful around grabbing something, touching something, making a sound with your hands.
They've done such a great job in the way they portray blindness or visual impairments.
Joe started to teach me about echolocation.
You make sound. And then find out the size of a room.
Oh, oh, beautiful room.
Where people are. I had no idea that was something that people could do.
Everything is conceptually designed to be authentic to what in a world would be like if most of the world didn't have sight.
The things we build are beautiful, but there's also a lot of logic built into it.
Like putting tap lines down the middle of the road, get their directions so they find a path.
The plates had individual little grooves around the edge of the charger so that the staff could actually figure out where the table setting is. In the wedding, the ribbons had bells on them so that everyone could hear the reaction.
With wardrobe, it forces you to use your other senses for fabrics, for touch, it's the texture, and then also, does it make sound?
I was really proud of everyone, how hard everyone trained.
Yes!
We work with every performer to help bring them in the world to see, and then this team really creates something beautiful.
on a date. There were gonna be flowers, and I was gonna light candles, and I was gonna shower and do my hair. Nobody messes with Vegas. How about you? And you?
Finally, Thor Odinson, Crown Prince of Asgard.
And you? And you?
You've been
Haven't you too?
Thor. Thor.
And you? And you?
Shh. Calm down. Thor Odinson, Crown Prince of Asgard. You've been chosen.
I'm getting increasingly concerned about this developing supercell southwest of the metro.
We expect a tornado outbreak beginning as early as noon.
Get that seed in yet?
It'll be done today.
Tornado warnings are just outside our viewing area. But we're under a particularly dangerous situation, Tornado Watch.
Don't worry about this. We're going to get through it.
We always do get through it, and we're going to get through it again.
Tornado! Everybody out! Tornado!
Follow me this way. Everybody hurry!
Are you sure this is the safest place to be?
Come on!
Do you have any information on a specific location?
It's us.
A tornado warning has been issued.
I know how hard this is. But we've got a whole town counting on us.
This is a 1 in 1,000 type warning.
How special Ace is to us.
He's so smart. He's like a big dog to me.
A big dog? Oh, come on, Daniel. Have you no idea my pedigree?
Merry Christmas, folks. It's a beautiful day in the Temecula wine country.
During the most festive of seasons, Amanda lost her holiday spirit.
Our business has been hit so hard, and I worry for Daniel's future.
Tony was also down and out on his luck.
Business is not so good.
When an unexpected opportunity brought their worlds together.
Babe, you could help me take care of the stables. This is Ace.
So you need a horse sitter? Easy, boy.
Open your eyes.
I'll just give him another Glasgow kiss. That'll fix him right up.
When I woke up, this horse was talking to me.
A talky horse? Too funny, Mom.
Why such a long face, Tony? What's got you troubled? Amanda says operating a ranch ain't cheap. Is that all this is about? Money? What if I help you win the annual Christmas Derby? So how are you gonna do that? Take me to the track. I've got a lot of friends who owe me favors.
This holiday season,
I'm gonna show you what loyalty and friendship is all about. What's happening, bro?
The race is on.
The purse is 1 million big ones.
To save their home.
Merry Christmas to all.
Brandi Roderick, Stephen Chase, and John Lovitz as the voice of Ace.
Maybe I'm here to show you that you always were the winner, Tony.
They're neck and neck, and down the stretch they come.
Yeah!
Ace and the Christmas Miracle.
It's a sure thing. Go for it. Your friend does run strangely. I think he was dropped on the head when he was a baby. That explains it.
So you know this island? It's kind of special, right?
Yeah, it's the island of the director you and Mommy like a lot.
Yep, that's it.
A lot of people come here to work.
Then come see
students, writers, designers.
Wow.
All this calm and perfection, I find it oppressive.
Soothing.
You know how hard writing is for me? It's torture, it's self-inflicted agony, it's blood from a stone.
Well, then do something else.
How's your thing going?
Pretty good, actually.
What's it about?
It's about how invisible things circulate within a couple.
Can I tell you about what I'm writing?
Yeah.
A young woman looks into the distance. She's about my age, or maybe a bit younger. They loved each other passionately and awkwardly, like teenagers do.
I never mentioned you to my girlfriend. But she's jealous of you.
Why her and not me? You spaced out.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't.
The attraction was still overwhelming. But there was no place in their lives for this love story anymore.
D'Angelo.
Please, call me Alana.
My son, Max.
Hi, Max.
Your daughter, does she take after you?
In some ways, except when she's digging in her heels. Then I can't help but see my late husband's stubbornness coming through.
Are you jealous?
He's cute, Sam, but he's not really my type.
You should get the best and the brightest that Middleton has to offer, put him on that stage, show the world who we are and why our school means so much to our community.
About my dad growing up, I certainly think about that seriousness. But very few people get to see. He's funny, weird, and really playful.
God help us.
In 1981, HIV/AIDS was evolving rapidly and frighteningly. There was anger at the government's response.
When you got sick, you were gone fast.
It's affecting you now.
Yeah.
Why?
Post-traumatic stress syndrome.
When COVID hit, he became this target.
My dad said, we're gonna get through this whole thing. And he's held that.
You don't do it because you wanna make money. You don't do it for the glory. You do it because you care.
When you're involved in a race to stop a horrible disease, you always feel you're not doing things quickly enough.
Hello, you. I'm so glad you're here.
Welcome to the town of Clover Grove.
Hello, Jack.
Hello, Jack.
Where one act of kindness,
surprise,
can grow and grow.
To help you finish your big game.
And start a chain of many more.
Come on, we can play the game with Cooper. Yeah! Welcome to the Hummingbird Cafe.
Try a little act of kindness.
Before. I'm imagining. Hello, bus.
Show a stranger some politeness.
Wanna sit next to me? We can be bus buddies.
That looks so great, Hugo.
Thanks. And thank you, Crims.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you got it, Hugo. Kindness starts with a simple hello.
Hello, you.
Hello, Jack. The Kindness Show. Exclusively streaming on Apple TV.
Pumpkins, Darcy, and lots of them. That's the secret to whole hog Halloween happiness.
Guess you cracked the code.
Oh, yeah. And this Halloween, we're not taking any chances. We're going to be up to our gourds in gourds on Joe Bob's Halloween Hoedown for a double feature of terrible people doing questionable things.
Are we finally showing Halloween 3?
Better! We're bringing on the Halloween 2, the two guys behind Halloween Kills, David Gordon Green and Jason Blum. So dust off your sharpest knife and join us on Joe Bob's Halloween Hoedown, Friday night, 9 p.m. Eastern, only on Shudder.
Hola!
I'm sorry, who are you? What are you doing in my house?
So dead. Points. You are Points. Such a drama queen.
I'm mad. I want you.
You can get away.
Who are you again?
I'm your Spanish teacher.
So I have to speak Spanish for one day.
Well, I actually bought the 100 lesson package.
Well, did you buy me 100 Spanish lessons?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you wanted to learn Spanish, dummy.
Oh.
Buenos días, Adam.
Yo no sé tu nombre.
Oh, todo el mundo me dice cariño. Como in Dirty Dancing, how everybody just calls baby, baby.
Ah.
I stalked your social media.
What?
I found out that it was your birthday, so ready, 1, 2, 3, here we go. Cumpleaños feliz. Cumpleaños a ti.
This is Will.
Mi nombre.
It's muy guapo. Hello? Is there anybody there?
La verdad es que estoy un poco perdido.
I just want to make sure that you're okay.
Sí. Lo siento.
¿Estás en Costa Rica?
Sí, es donde vivo.
Hola, papá.
Dos personas pueden jugar este juego.
What I wanted to say, but I was kind of afraid to say, is...
Adam!
Yes?
Adam!
Yes?
Stop calling me so late, so unprofessional.
It's like a rumble from the core of the earth. This is probably 6,000 years old.
Oh.
Yes. Drilled into her head to release bad spirits.
I can do this.
Look at me. Do you love her?
I caught you.
I was placing the flower
in your mouth.
Ben, I met someone. Interesting guy called Justin. What do you love most about your work?
I love creating memories.
And we kissed last night.
Oh no, he has a girlfriend. Hey, we make a pretty good team, don't we?
Me, you, and your girlfriend.
What is even going on between us? Because it feels like you don't even love me anymore.
Well, it feels like I'm just here for your inconvenience.
We're the flower sisters. We gotta keep blooming.
Bloom, 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 Jessica.
Drop it. I'll get up, okay?
He kissed you because his heart told him to. It's about time you start listening to yours.
Choose a movie, sis. Crazy middle class agent. I know I'm supposed to be strong and get over it really quick, but it's different this time. I love him.
Some bowls for you. And some sausages for you.
They're really small.
Those are.
It's Sarah Jessica.
Hello from New York City, Fifth Avenue. Shooting, as we speak, the next chapter of Sex and the City, or as we like to call it, and just like that, with some beloved friends. But in the meantime, and just like that, will premiere in December on HBO Max. Ciao.
Waystar, plant a flag, fix up my lawyer, PRs, get some independent directors shaking, and maybe ride in to see the feds.
No comment! No comment! No comment!
You don't have to say
no
that.
No comment!
You don't have to say that, Greg. Just don't comment.
Family, come on!
Okay, Jess, let's go.
This is a company vehicle.
What?
I mean, I don't have a dog in this fight, but since you just clearly opened the company up to investigations, lawsuits, I imagine you're no longer working for the company.
Well, no, because I was acting in the best interest of the company.
Yeah, violating your duty of confidentiality, violating your fiduciary duties as a director.
Look, I need a sealed unit here, Carolina. I need a clean jar, so are you in for this f***ing revolution?
No, I know, it's exciting. I
Are you with me, yes or no?
Why did you do it like that, Ken? I mean, did you know?
Me? No. I had no prior warning, and I was surprised at his comments, but now I am obviously concerned and interested to hear more.
Okay.
This is a fork in your life, Carolyn. This is the righteous vehicle.
Light of the gods.
The sacred bloom traveled, and my dreams traveled with it.
It is unspeakable power. Whatever you dream, you will have.
It's too late to change what has happened. But not too late to change what will be.
Why bring me here?
We all have masters to serve.
She will know sorrow.
Our people have suffered long enough.
I am enlightened.
Consummate character actor, a character actor who became a star.
That face was just so magical.
There is not a single movie I've ever done that is not under the shadow that this man casts.
This storm will be magnificent.
He kind of backs in to the scene and turns around slowly and the lights, and there's that face. You can't imagine a better entrance.
You can show that image to almost anyone in the world. What's this? Frankenstein!
In The Bride of Frankenstein, they virtually crucify the monster.
I saw my messiah.
The gods will receive into the underworld the spirit of Ankh-Zanaman.
He had just an extraordinary career. I mean, everybody raves about him.
People think of him as either British or Russian.
but he was actually of Indian descent.
There were various things he didn't want to talk about.
What was he running away from when he left home? What was he frightened of?
He becomes kind of a lovable uncle. He was Uncle Boris.
He was a very, very interesting, complex man.
But he's always an outsider, always feels he doesn't quite belong.
You'll never get rid of me, Toddy.
I think there's an enigma. There's a real mystery at the heart of Boris Karloff, and no one's quite cracked it yet.
Certain actors bring the camera to them, and Karloff had that power.
The way I've always been doing things just doesn't work now. I want to be free.
You're a freak. You're fat. Your hair is gross. You're a baby. You smell. Don't be a bitch. Everyone can see you. You should be falling in love. There. Don't you feel better now?
I feel weird lately.
Are you sick?
You know, the committee in your head that tells you that you're a terrible person.
You're nothing.
Just never really noticed it before. You know what I'm talking about.
Sure.
You're a loser.
Are you okay?
You're so selfish.
I just don't feel like I'm on top of things.
Loosen up.
The way I've always been doing things just doesn't work now.
You're so beautiful, so delicate, I feel sick.
I've been telling myself to do certain things.
Hey, Sugar Plum.
Let it go.
Act a certain way.
There's nothing better than watching her get all excited.
Don't cause a scene.
Or else something bad will happen to me.
How could you be so stupid?
Maybe you cast yourself in a part you don't want to play anymore.
You're a pretty little flower.
I'm scared to do things differently.
You're going to fail.
I'm not listening to that voice.
What did you say?
I'm a sucker for the power.
You'll never find your way back to that kind of freedom.
I don't want to be afraid of some terrible outcome. I want to be free.
This is a huge mistake.
I want to be free.
No one will even want to come near you. You will be alone. Alone. Alone.
I want to be free.
Has died.
Media
at the age of
paparazzi
32.
Surrounded the home that she shared with her husband Simon Monjak.
Simon took her away. He made sure no one could get to her.
Hi, my name is Brittany Murphy, and I go to Herbert Hoover Middle School.
Brittany was so wonderful. There was nobody else like her.
There was kind of a sweet, childish, lost quality that she had that just breaks your heart.
She was successful immediately.
You cannot be a teen girl and not love Britney in 8 Mile, Clueless. These are movies that will stand the test of time. Britney Murphy was super cute, but in Hollywood, you have to be Gwyneth Paltrow.
She was not a typical pretty girl, and so many young women in Hollywood are pressured enormously. She had lost an inordinate amount of weight, and she was dressing totally differently.
She said, "That's what I've been told. If I wanted to be considered as a leading lady." During a little dip she was having, he came along. And I think that's where her judgment was muddled, and she became prey.
Simon said that he was the largest collector of Vermeer, dated Elle Macpherson and Madonna. He said that he had been dying from terminal brain cancer and that he had bought an experimental treatment derived from the fins of sharks. Every single word out of his mouth was a lie.
We all were scared and freaked out. Like, who was this guy?
Once they got married, they were holed up in that house 24/7.
Nobody got close to her.
Last one, actually.
You start to think, well, okay, who gained from her dying?
There were more unanswered questions after the autopsy came out than there were answered questions.
People start thinking,
There's more behind this. There's something else.
Simon had all these secrets.
He actually said people in the government were watching them. Brittany's dad was sure someone had done it.
You visibly see mold.
Is the house cursed?
Something made her sick. A healthy 32-year-old doesn't just die.